Hello friends, welcome back to the video lecture series Seekho Punjab, in which we are discussing the geography of Punjab. Today is the 7th lecture. In the previous lectures we have covered soils, rivers, climate, general introduction and other such facets. If you wish to revise, then you must revise. In the 7th lecture we are going to cover forest cover and the biodiversity in the region of Punjab. So let's not waste time, going straight to the first slide. In this we are going to cover the following topics. First we will introduce the concept, we will try to find out the status of forest cover in Punjab, we will discuss the districts having the maximum and the least cover. Then we will discuss the protected areas in Punjab. Protected areas will include conservation reserve, community reserve, wildlife sanctuaries, use and VHS. Now let us move to the first slide, that is the introduction. The recorded forest area in the state is 3011 square kilometer, which constitutes 6% of the geographical area of the state. This 6% is very much less. Out of this 6%, out of this area, then this division is further has been demarcated here between reserve forest, protected forest and unclassified forest. Normally when we perceive, when we think about forest, then we feel that kafi ghane jangal, kafi vriksh wala area hamare man mein aata hai, lekin jab Punjab ke sandarbh mein forest ki baat karte hain to aisa nahi hai. The forest cover in Punjab mainly includes the trees planted around the roads, canals and rivers. So like this is again a shocking fact for we people, that already the forest cover is less and this is the state. Coming to the next slide. The district wise forest area intensity. Highest in Hoshiarpur, then Ropar, then third is Namashahar and fourth is Gurdaspur. We will also look up for these districts in the map. But you will find that all these districts are touching the northeastern border and these districts are near the area of Shivalik Range. This is the area where perhaps the rainfall is also higher. So why in this particular area the forest cover is high? We will find basic two reasons. First, the land here is not suitable for cultivation and because the area is lying vacant, so it is being used for plantation of trees. Because the precipitation is high, some small streams, rivers are there, so these plants get automatically irrigated, automatically watered, so they can sustain themselves. So these are the reasons behind the high coverage in Hoshiarpur, Ropar, Namashahar and Gurdaspur. Next, we are trying to find the areas where the forest cover is less. You will find all the areas in the southern belt, namely Sangrur, Moga, Sangrur, Moga, Muktsar, Freecode, Bathinda, Mansa and Ferozpur. The intensity is even lesser than 2%. The main trees which are planted here, the Shisham, State Tree, Kikar, Eucalyptus and Khair. The reasons behind the less coverage, less forest coverage is, first the land is very suitable, either the land is very suitable for agriculture or it is not suitable for anything. It's a desert land, so you can't expect the forest to be there. So and also the water availability, the precipitation is lesser here. So these are the reasons. And the previous slide, you want to draw on the map, then this is the Hoshiarpur, which is having the maximum percentage of the forest cover. Then comes Ropad, Namashahar, and Gurdaspur. Let us move to the next slide. With the protected areas of Punjab. Protected areas are those in which human occupation or disturbance or exploitation has either been restricted or has been limited. As per the Wildlife Protection Act 1972, there are four types of protected areas. One is a national park, second is wildlife sanctuary, third is community reserve and conservation reserve. These categories have been added later on. In Punjab, an area of 340 square kilometers is being managed as protected area under 13 wildlife sanctuaries, 1 conservation reserve, 2 community reserves. Punjab has got total 21 wetlands. This has been covered in the previous lecture. So now we are going to discuss some of these. Conservation reserve. This category of protected area can be declared by state governments in any area owned by the government, particularly the areas adjacent to the national park or sanctuaries, and those areas which link one protected area with another. Such declaration should be made after consultation with local communities. So, the basic purpose of conservation reserve is to protect the landscape, seascape, flora, fauna and their habitat. The right of people living inside a conservation reserve are not affected. In Punjab, we are having only one conservation reserve, that is in the district of Tarantaran. The name is Raksarai Amanat Khan Conservation Reserve. It was notified in 2010. The concept will come more clear when we will discuss the differences between community and conservation reserve. Now comes the community reserve. These are two in number in Punjab. First ever notified in the country in 2007. Community reserve can be declared by the state government in any private or community land not comprised with the national park, sanctuary or conservation reserve, where an individual or a community has volunteered to conserve wildlife and its habitat. Again, the purpose is same. Or cultural, this is the addition, cultural conservation values. Rights of people living inside a community reserve are not affected again. Almost similar concept. The differences will make you clear what is the difference between the two. There are two community reserves in Punjab. Keshopur Champ Community Reserve in Gurdaspur district, Lalwan Community Reserve in Hoshiarpur district. So, conservation reserve, one in number in Tarantaran district, community reserve, one in Gurdaspur and one in Hoshiarpur district. Now comes the differences between the community and conservation reserve. See, community reserve, as a name, is indicating towards the community. Here, the land is either partially or fully owned by a private person or a community, and they have taken a lead to conserve one of the pillars of the conservation there. Like it might be wildlife, it might be habitat, but the initiative has been taken by the community itself in the land which has been owned partially or fully by them. And the government comes to support such effort, then it is called community reserve. The conservation reserve, on the other hand, is is area is declared conservation reserve only when the land is not privately owned. It is normally owned by the government and nobody is residing there permanently. People might be frequenting there for some purpose, but nobody is having, it is not inhabited, in other words. Purposes are almost similar, we have already discussed. In both the concepts, the lead is taken by the community itself. The government supports it. Normally such areas these areas categories were added because of reduced protection in and around existing and proposed protected areas due to private ownership of land and land use. In both the cases, conservation efforts are by local community only. These concepts were added in 2002 as an amendment. So I think now the concept has become, must have become more clearer. Moving to the next slide, the wildlife sanctuaries. Again, under the Wildlife Act of 1972, this is another protected area type where wildlife or its environment is protected, propagated or developed. So wildlife sanctuaries are not only for wildlife itself, it's for the environment also. Certain rights of people living inside the sanctuary could be permitted. In Punjab, we have mentioned the 13 names of wildlife sanctuaries. Harike Patan is in Tarn Taran. These are other names. The list is here. The PPT will be put up and everybody may remember these names. May become important for MCQs. You can just look into Nangal Wildlife, Jajjar Bacholi Wildlife, Bir Ashwan Wildlife, this is in Sangrur, Bid Padso, Bid Dosanjh, Bid Mehsas, these are the wildlife sanctuaries. I am moving to the next slide now. These are zoological parks in Punjab. Since childhood, I have been hearing one name, Chhat Bid Chidiyakar. This Mahinder Chaudhary Zoological Park or Chhat Bid Zoo, this is a zoological park near Zirakpur. Different mammals, birds and reptiles may be seen there. Other zoological park is Ludhiana Zoo. Tiger Safari is here. Again in Ludhiana district, another mini zoo is there. In Patiala also, Deer Park Bid Moti Bagh is here. In Bathinda, Deer Park Bid Talab is here. So these are the famous zoological parks in Punjab. One concept which is BHS, Biodiversity Heritage Sites. Under Section 37 of Biological Diversity Act 2002, the state government has been empowered to identify these BHS with the consultation by consulting with the local bodies. They can notify it in the official gazette. These are the areas of biodiversity importance. In Punjab, we have declared these areas as BHS. Inami Bagh in Hoshiarpur, elite mango varieties are there. If you remember during our discussion regarding the topography, physiography, we mentioned that this area of Hoshiarpur is not, and also during the discussion of soil, we found that this area is not suitable for normal agriculture, but it's suitable for horticulture. So now you can correlate that Inami Bagh, which is famous for mango varieties, have been declared as BHS in Hoshiarpur. Chhatpat Bani in village Kataru Chak in Pathankut. Kayakalp Briksh, it's in Fatehgarh Sahib. The efforts are on to get this briksh declared, Kayakalp Briksh declared, the Great Banyan Tree declared as biodiversity, biological diversity, this biodiversity tree. If it is declared, then it will become the first such tree. these areas outside Harike Wildlife Sanctuary, so these fall under BHS. Urban biodiversity heritage sites are also there. Amkhas Bagh and Ram Bagh in District Amritsar, Baradari Garden, Patiala, Shalimar Garden, Kapurthala, and Royal Garden in Faridkot. So this was the concept of BHS under Section 37 of Biological Diversity Act 2002. Now, that was our effort to create and upload such series regarding the geography of Punjab, which are very user friendly, very comprehensive, and as per the requirement of the syllabus of the student. So this effort which we have taken, I think you must have find it useful for you, whether it was or not. What was the lacuna? What things may be improved? Please comment. If you find useful, then share so that other people may also watch the videos. We will be trying to upload more videos related to the general awareness, general knowledge of Punjab, so that students may get all this knowledge free of cost at their homes. Till the time you get the next videos, revise the videos, share the videos, comment on the videos. Take care, have a healthy lifestyle. Jai Hind. Best wishes from our side.